against the Netherlands. Our defense has been great. Like, they've been really good, but we are one of, I think there's only two teams that scored two goals and made it through. And I don't know, man, the fact that we scored two goals in three games is a little bit concerning. I'm just hoping that our defense plays well. Pulisic should be back, and hopefully we can give him a little bit of a run, but it's going to be a tough matchup in the next round for the U.S. for sure. Argentina makes it through after starting out with a loss to Saudi Arabia, which was kind of the upset of the tournament, honestly. Like, when that happened, I was like, this might get weird. But they do end up at the top of their group, so they figured it out after that. They make it through with Poland as well. This one actually got close. It got very close, and it came down to... Wait, hold up. So they tied on points. Okay, so this was the one that came down to fair play points, or no. No, it almost did. It almost did, but then Mexico got scored on towards the end of the game, so Poland made it through on goal differential. So it goes, the tiebreakers, it goes, so first of all, your points, if you're tied on points, then it goes to goals for, and then I believe it's goal differential between, like, the two teams that are tied, like how much they scored against each other, and then eventually it goes down to like fair play points, like how many yellows or red cards you have. It gets a little crazy, but luckily it didn't come down to that. So Argentina and Poland make it through. France advance as well out of Group D, as well as Australia. Australia with a minus 1 point differential, but they're able to pick up 6 points. Very solid. I picked Denmark out of this one, actually. Yeah, and they only got 1 point, which is kind of surprising. But man, Group E, this ended up being crazy. For a second, for just a little second, looking like Japan and Costa Rica might make it through. I believe Costa Rica went up 2-1 against Germany. Germany ended up winning 4-2. But if Costa Rica had won that game, Japan obviously won against Spain. But if Costa Rica beat Germany, then Costa Rica and Japan would have eliminated Spain and Germany, two of the top teams in the world, and that would have been insane. I'm still shocked that Germany wasn't able to make it through. I had picked them to make it through. I really thought they were a lock. But man, yeah, I mean, that's tough. But I mean, Japan totally deserved it, man. I'm happy for them. If you beat Spain, like, I can't believe Japan out of this group, they only lost to Costa Rica. They beat Spain and they beat Germany, so they deserve to make it through. Spain kind of played a little bit weird in their game against Costa Rica, but that's another subject altogether. surprise, really, but Brazil is going to need Neymar back if they're going to need it, if they're going to make a deep run here in the cup. So hopefully he's back soon for them. Portugal advances first in their group, as well as South Korea. So I had picked Uruguay to make it through. I picked Portugal and Uruguay. I mean, Uruguay just, they just didn't play well enough, man. And I was watching their game. Who are they playing last? Will it tell us if we click on them? Yeah, they were playing against Ghana. They needed one more goal to advance on goal differential. Shoving them and stuff, and like that was just such a bummer to see, man. It's like, first of all, like, you can't wait till the last game to score a goal. Like, they hadn't scored a single goal until they played Ghana. Like, y'all have nobody to blame but yourselves, but to be like shoving the refs and stuff like that, like, that's just something that really irks me. Like, I can't stand that. Especially when, like, you had, you know, these other games to take advantage, and you just didn't. I mean, the teams that made it through deserve to make it through, and unfortunately, Uruguay did not. So, okay, here we go. So, this is the knockout bracket. So I made a, I'm just trying to upload a quick video here. I made a very, like, terrible, very crude little chart of my picks. These are the picks that I had in my original video. So I had Netherlands, USA, which turned out to be right, and I picked Netherlands to win that one. Switching that to the US. But yeah, I did pick the Netherlands originally. I'm switching that to US. Let's go, boys. Next up, I picked Argentina and Denmark. Denmark did not make it through, so it's Argentina and Australia. I'm still gonna stick with Argentina. I still think they're a favorite to win most talented. Next to Brazil. Maybe Spain too. You can probably throw maybe England. You can throw. There's like four teams. Like those four teams, I feel like, will end up winning. Maybe five. I mean, Argentina could sneak in too. I don't know. This is why you gotta watch the games. This is why I love the World Cup. There's so many teams that can make a run. Like, you don't know, like, who could knock off who. So, that's why I love it so much. But yeah, so we have France here. Next up, Morocco and Spain. I just think Spain is too good. They played the possession game so well. Like, they had 80%+ possession in their last game, and they lost. And some people say they may have lost intentionally for positioning so they could play against Morocco, but in any case, because I remember growing up, and it's not the same thing, but, you know, we would play against teams that would try to do the same thing. Like, they just possess the ball, they don't really, you know, they just play very carefully, and you spend so much time defending that eventually you're gonna make mistakes, and that's what Spain counts on, and that's how they capitalize. And they just kind of wear you down, and it's just frustrating to play against. I hate it so much, but it works great. It works very well. Next up, we got Portugal and Switzerland. I did pick that one. And I picked Portugal to begin with. I'm going to pick Portugal here. Okay, so it actually doesn't let me, like, fill in the bracket again. And I don't know. I don't really want to, like, revise my picks too much, so we'll do like an updated video after every round, and just to do like an update on how things are going, like who I think's gonna win each matchup. But honestly, I'm not mad about my bracket. So we got two teams right, three teams, four teams, five, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So I got 11 of 16. And I mean, honestly, the ones I missed, like Belgium, Germany, how could you predict that? Like, that still blows my mind that both of them missed out, but that's why you play the game right there, boys. Anywho. That is going to do it for this one. Leave a comment down below. Let me know if you guys have a favorite coming out of this round of 16. If you think there's any upsets coming up here soon. I'm just really excited to watch. I would love to see, like, some crazy upset. That's why I enjoy it. You know, you never know what's going to happen, but hopefully we get some good games. I'll be starting out with Netherlands and US. Oh, I'm nervous. I'm excited, but I'm nervous. I just hope it's a good game, man. Put up a good fight, and we'll call it good. I mean, just for the US to make it to the round of 16, I mean, that's a dub just by itself. But anywho, guys, that is going to do it for this one.